Hello there everyone, and welcome back to Ultimate General Gettysburg. So I got a great response on the first video. I haven't released the second video, but as we all know there, my attack over towards Cemetery Ridge and Cemetery Hill there didn't go very well. I was close, but I made some mistakes. So go from an epic victory to major defeat, I think it was described as. So we could, as this, attack Cemetery Hill, if applicable now. So I guess we will bring the same sort of people on top of it. And I feel as though they're really tired, and going at it once more might not be the case. And then we have other attack here, which would be yesterday was a great day for our army. The Yankees couldn't hold our advance and withdrew to the south. Our troops are in high spirit, and General Longstreet soon will join us with his corps. The Federals are deploying on the high ground south of town. We have to keep the pressure on and immediately launch a strong attack on the cemetery area. If we take those hills, we will win the battle. Then we can march to Washington without major assistance. We must find the job today. We must finish the job today. So I guess this is unlike this, which I guess we have the. It doesn't say anything about Longstreet joining. So it's basically a continuation on the attack, and I guess this is. Tomorrow fresh reinforcement. So I guess this would be continuing on late in the night, as it says. Let's see, where did it say that? Yeah, take the hill before nightfall. I'm not sure if there, or if this, or everything of this is the second day. Or if we should go. So we have attack on the. Both of these are going. Not entirely sure what the difference is here between the attack on Cemetery Hill and the attack on Cemetery. Because it looks very similar with a three-pronged attack. It's just the difference of the fact that, what's that, the something corps have moved actually in to position there. And then we have the possibility of coming on the left. The Yankees have retreated to Cemetery Hill. We drove them off the town, but we cannot continue pressing on the attack. Our army's tired, and we still don't know how many Federals hide behind those hills. Tomorrow, with fresh reinforcement, we'll make a better attempt to outflank the left side. So I'm thinking about going for this case, since we get more fresh troops, and I think that Longstreet will be one of the joining here, and we can see about swinging up here and attacking. We've got a little round top there, I believe. And then attacking towards the left. But I'm not sure. It's one of those because you can't really go back and like load if you were like, damn it. And you don't get really the full view of things, what can happen or how you have to do it and stuff. Which also plays into the sort of good parts in the game that it's sort of, you know, the fact that I failed last time and there wasn't really a makes the each campaign makes for a different thing, and the fact that you can switch in between the different types of how the AI works, is going to be cunning, is it going to be aggressive, and so on, makes for, even though you're only playing Gettysburg, it gets quite a lot of replayability, which I like. And someone actually asked about the AI. So far, I've mostly played as the Confederates. I did play as the Union and defended. But I haven't. Since I've only played it a little bit, I haven't really tested out anything more than balanced. But I think if you test out the others, you might see surprising stuff within the AI. So far, I can't say I've been super impressed by the AI. It handles well, I must say that, compared to, say, the predictability that I sometimes get with the Total War ones. Once you get to a certain stage within the Total War, you sort of know how the AI will work. Or at least in those games that I played a lot. Now that's a lot different because I've played this for maybe a bit more than 10 hours or something, while I've played most of the Total War ones for at least 500 or more. But I think we're gonna test out going here on the left, and hopefully this is the right choice. Right, so going on the left was not very good at all. We have 3,000 men to start off with against their 17,000, and then they expect a reinforcement of 21,000 compared with our reinforcements of 22. We'll have this. They have more guns, they have more troops, they have almost twice the amount of troops. So this will be a hell of a fight. But what I can see is that there's a big concentration up on the northern side towards where we actually attacked, and there seems to be a light defense right here. The bad thing is, of course, that we don't start with any guns at all. So we have no artillery support at all. We have 3,000 men against 17,000, and this is gonna be a hard battle, to say the least. I get two troops. Alexander's gun. What's all of this? Alexander's guns are ready to shell the Yankees. Good. General Hood's division has finally arrived. We made launched an envelopment attack on Emmitsburg Road. Major Andrews' artillery battalion of Hood's division has come. His plan is to deploy near the Peach Orchard. The Peach Orchard. Where is that? Isn't that the Peach Orchard? Is this? Or is that even... up there. We've got a point that we need to cap there. Artillery Battalion Hood's division has come. His plan to burn a Peach Orchard. Campbell's artillery of General McClaw's division has arrived in neat position on the high ground. McClaw's division, something something dark side, something something complete. Right, we're gonna try to go in. Little Round Top is the main thing. We're gonna have to send something up there to capture it. But most troops and most artillery pieces will be used for the attack on Little Round Top, since, as it was laid out on the map, there was quite a few. Actually, it says we got 15,000 men, which I'm surprised. And it says we have 60 guns, which I find strange, because I was thinking that I would be quite outnumbered. Question is if the Yankees would be bold enough to actually go out there to take that. But we need someone to hold that, so we'll send up Benning. Benning will march up, because he's got the lowest amount of troops. Anderson, Texas Brigade, and Law will move into attack positions from here and try to march up, so we stay away from most of this. And then we'll have to see about the high points. That's very 664 yards or meters. That's very high up. 444. So this place is actually higher than this. 464, 440. Right. Gonna try to stay away from the Devil's Den as much as possible, since we don't want to drag in more troops from up there. But Anderson is gonna march up to that hill, and then the Texas Brigade will come in on his right, and Law will come in on his right. And then we want the infantry to move up first. Or maybe we move up the artillery first. We don't have a general present. Because that was one of the things I think I failed on in the last one. Actually, maybe I should move them on to this. It's more of a safer spot, I think, to move two artillery pieces over there and then move this one up to into the woods there. Not sure how well they will be able to fire across, but right, this is the plan for now. As I was saying, one of the problems I think I had with the last attack was that I wasn't able to use my artillery properly, as I said, in the game, but I also think I missed out on the usage of... Here we actually got the general coming in, and looks like we got even more artillery coming in as well. Got first corps. I want you to push up there. We got a lot of artillery coming in. And we got a lot of troops coming in, which I like. But we'll focus on these two spots. Actually, it says Little Round Top here. I thought this was Little Round Top. But I guess this one is smaller. This is Round Top, and this is Little Round Top. Ah. My mistake. Kershaw, Barksdale. The entire point is to outflank them, but we might still want to have some ready to go across there. We got sharpshooters spotted. We want to focus our artillery. Oh! Ah, the enemy has already moved into position and taken. We're actually gonna have to fight for that point. We got a hell of a lot of artillery coming in here. We're gonna have to send more people north then. Because I think if we can't even capture this one, and then it's gonna be very... Ah, crap. Artillery's on the fire by the bloody... Attack the sharpshooters now. And then the cannons come on the fire. They're just gonna have to bear the brunt of that. As the sharpshooters pull back. There's no point in you hanging back there. Get up and on point. Ooh, we got the third corps there, quite a lot of them. We're sort of being dragged in by the first US sharpshooters into a battle there. Ah, I guess the trees are in the way. We'll have to move them up, but for now that I guess they give good cover. But it might be good for the enemy to focus more troops as they marched up from over there. We don't want to be stuck out there, so you have to continue for now. We're giving a hell of a lot of artillery fire right here, but there's not a lot of people dying compared with Benning, which is pulled into a bad spot, actually. Benning, fall back. They've been pulled into a very bad spot. Run out of there. Run! I should have pulled them back earlier. Thing is, though, there's a lot more Union troops here. So I think if we can push the enemy off here, that would be nice, but You can halt, and now we want you to go in the flank there. If we can take these 2 points, that would be nice if we could take that one. But I think if we... the focus would be on that point and this point. This artillery has not really good position, but once we've taken this hill, we can move all the artillery up here, and then we can shell down from this very high point, which will be very good. Maybe I should actually focus my men even further up here. So focus them more, even further up. Once we're ready in position, I think maybe I'll push the artillery up through the forest so we'll get a better view. But right now they're pretty well covered. But at the same time it looks like they're not getting that many good hits. There's a lot of artillery and a lot of men there. But looks as though they've completely forgot about putting troops up at... round top. The artillery here is not faring very well. First corps, you will move now, and we don't need the artillery there, so time to move. There's no resistance on the hill. Push those sharpshooters off. It's a big... I think maybe we've spotted all of this because we've... or maybe we put... well, because Barksdale was pushed up. More Yankee... let's see, Yankee artillery spotting coming from Heights. We are reading it round top. Union infantry heading reinforced, little round top. More Yankees battery scene. So now we're gonna see a fight go down up here. It's good then that I start moving artillery pieces. Yeah, we see troops moving now. Ooh, they're sending a lot of troops actually. I want you over there right now. Texas Brigade, move. They're running. They're pushing everything. Look, they're abandoning this position rather quickly. Push forwards now. That's an interesting move by the AI here. That they've been completely surprised by my move to take the hill. And now they're sort of almost... you can see almost like a panic move. Moving away. Move up the artillery a bit. Get through the forest, I think. Or at least these that are formed in the back. Texas Brigade, you will wheel. Law, push up. Artillery, push up. Kershaw, push up. Now I almost wished I hadn't moved these guys up here, because these guys are put in flank positions. And we could have easily done a flank attack there. Crap, Barksdale is taking a lot of damage from the artillery. Texas, you will wield on my command. Anderson, you will hold that position. Halt. It's not that important we take this. Ooh, the morale went back on Barksdale pretty darn quick. Well, you need to support your ally. Actually, if we can push these cannons up even further. Actually, if we put these guys to support these. We have these. Yankee infantry spotter must press the attack before they come closer. Wheel, Peugeot, wheel. God damn you. The artillery here is losing morale. I might want to move the artillery. We want to move some artillery there. And then I think I'm actually going to move some artillery back here. To get flanking artillery on this hill. Where are you going? Yes, let's just push a cannon right in the middle of the fight here. Kershaw, start moving to engage Hall. Yeah, they're both falling back. Benning, Holt. We're gonna have to hold off on this. This is not a very important position anyways. Might want to pull this back back a bit. It's not a super important position. This one is the most important one. Well, these two are the most important one when it comes to the amount of points they're worth. The thing is, I'm loads to move the general from this position. Since if we lose here, battle is over. Starting to pull down artillery fire. It's gonna do well. This position is contested. The only thing we need to do is basically push these back, and the position is ours. Paul is taking heavy damage. He's about to break, I think. Actually, this artillery piece will go all the way over there. Oh, these guys, they're still rolling their cannon around. Right. They're not really able to fire here. I want them to fire on Ward. The thing is, the enemy does not seem to be super concerned on pushing up and holding this position. They're keeping a lot of men in reserve just to hold this. They've only got their artillery pieces around here are getting wrecked by my artillery. But the morale of my artillery is not that good. So I would want to move the general to support him, because I believe when he's close, the morale stays safe. But moving them from here right now, we possibly got Bank, Day, and I'm not sure with Reed, I think it said. Looks like they're coming to reinforce this position. We got good flanking from Kershaw into Vincent. Svajca is holding, Ward is holding, Anderson holding strong. It's a hard struggle there. And then we got this Benning versus Graham. We'll have Sims move in to aid. If we just can push these guys off, the position will be ours, and we can hold like one unit there. First sharpshooters are moving away. Ooh, Gilbert is doing nice. McIntosh Artillery Battalion, Pendus Division is ready to go into action from up here. Not where I need artillery. I need artillery down here. At this point. Yes, Ward is moving off. We need this guy to move off. And then we're ready to move sort of a bit forward there. And then we can have the Texas Brigade move forward together with Laws and Kershaws to claim this. Ah, Third Corps. Nice. Come in and support these cannons and the attack on Vent's Farm, or the Peach Orchard, we should say. Third Corps. Down artillery shots. These guys. Yankee reinforcement, more troops. Yankee bastards. Anderson, if you can just get, and Texas Brigade, if they can actually get like a proper thing going here. And if the artillery would want to, I don't think they're able to fire from the current position. Maybe I should move them a bit back to actually get on the center or up here on the actual top so they can fire up above my men, because it doesn't seem like they're able to right now. Ah, nice. Graham is now falling back. Where's the artillery that was supposed to come in there? It's only the general there in Third Corps. It's got low morale. He should be able to start transferring some stuff over to his troops. That is actually his artillery piece. We are winning at the Peach Orchard. Damn. Jordan's artillery is not faring good up there. We'll have to pull him back. Texas Brigade has done well. They've got good cover as well. There's more general something. I didn't have time to read that. Something was here to support us. I want to move out to take that. Excelsior Brigade is moving up. Can move up just a bit to actually claim that. Barksdale. Benning. Benning just can come here and support shooting at these guys. Why are they firing all the way over there? I want you guys to fire. Yes! Push them back, push them back. We are now outnumbered by almost 10,000 men. Law. Hold. No, 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 no. Oh, how do I disable this shit? Oh, how did I manage to do this? There we go. You will hold. Kershaw will hold. Texas Brigade is the only one that I want to move up. Anderson will hold there in the artillery, and you will. I don't want to move the entire corps. Battle is delayed, hopefully enough so I can capture this, because if I can capture this, I will capture, let's see, 3 out of 4 points. Ah! More troops, but a push towards here is not exactly where I want, and it's a bit too late. Well, I can do a general push to push them back from here, I guess. Although these guys are not the strongest bunch. Texas Brigade, now you will hold. You will hold that point. Anderson, wield! Wield to face the enemy. General Anderson is coming in as well. They're pulling in more men now. Look at them moving. We have to push up. Maybe it's a trick. We want to push up to Texas. It's all down to the Texas Brigade. And if the Texas Brigade can hold that. Benning, I want you to move up to start helping Anderson with his flank. Wilcox. What was this? Someone. And someone. Right, we're stopping a lot. Trying to stop as many men from coming towards Texas Brigade. No, 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 Texas Brigade! Fuck, Law is gonna move back, isn't he? This is not what I need, not right now. Yes, they're falling back. Anderson, push! God damn it, Anderson! I want you over there. I wanted you over there yesterday. Now get a move on! We must hold that point. Ah, the Texas Brigade, what are you doing? No! Texas Brigade retreated that way. And they retreated right into some Yankee bastards, and Benning, just seeing the massacre, is being scared off. Anderson, well, if you just hold there, then we got more people coming in, but it's in the wrong part of the battlefield. This is not gonna help anything. Really. Ooh, the Texas Brigade. They got so many casualties fleeing through there. The thing is, I want to sort of relocate Law's Brigade, Law, closer here. But if I do, they might break. And we don't want that. So, what I'm thinking is we pull the artillery closer towards that position. Burbank is moving a push towards Anderson, but I think Anderson can hold it. Ah, no, look at that. We're starting to drop influence over that point. Put pressure up here. I need another brigade up there. Benning! Texas! Even though you're so tired, you're not gonna do anything. There's too many bastards here. Although they're very tired. Artillery up there. Yankees running there, Yankees running there. We can keep on the push. Artillery pieces. You will move to the hill. Burbank, yeah, they're being pushed back. Keep up the offensive. Kershaw can actually push you into the flank there of McCandless. Hopefully that will free up Law to move a bit closer to the point. Ooh, Anderson does not, he's suffering a lot here. See how close the troops are right here, firing at each other. Kershaw? I don't like your angle. Nice, we're pushing them off. This one is becoming grayer and grayer. Hold. Hold. on, break these bastards. Oh crap, where did these bastards come up from? Crap. Fall back. Ah, hell. What the hell are these guys coming doing? We got nothing for a charge. Charge. Hold. Anderson, push up. It's gray now. Kershaw is holding them back. Get a move on. We lost little round top. Halt. Halt. No, Law is falling back. Hold. Thomas, get up there on the hill. Law, goddammit, reform your men. Texas Brigade, nothing. Hold, hold. Crap, they're facing the wrong way. Turn around, fire! God damn it, day. I'm gonna push you off there, I'm gonna push artillery right up your ass. Kershaw, you will hold. Crap, I forgot about a lot of cannons back here. Pause. Get these guys up. Actually, there's a high spot. So close. So close. This is even closer than the last one. No! Damn it! It's turning blue. Now Kershaw's being shot. If I tell him to run, he's gonna break completely. Anderson! Damn you, Anderson! Get back there! Law. Benning, at least hold on to this. There's simply too many Yankees. Ah, now Kershaw's falling apart. There's simply too many. I'm fighting against. They're numbering us 10th. Should have pulled more men around. Down towards here. I wasn't expecting them to push up this many people. At this point, I don't think it looks like we're gonna be able to take this one, so if the delay could just end, so we can just put me out of my misery. We at least held this, and we took a round top. Where's the third corps general? Well, hopefully the Yankees paid for it. But I'm not so sure about it. Now I sort of just want the time to run out so I don't lose this as well. They're ready with canisters as soon as something comes into range. God damn it, Riley, fire. Blow them away. Look at the damage on Kershaw. They were doing so well until I missed that. There's a lot of bodies here close by to the Devil's Den and on the little round top. If I at least could get it to switch gray so it's not actually Union controlled. Crap, that looks like they're pulling up everything. Yeah, no, law's not gonna hold, damn it. Yeah, there's no point. We're not gonna be able to take this. But we'll make sure that we secure round top. See if we can hit Excelsior there in the side to push them back a bit. Every time I see it, the Excelsior Brigade, I think of that. This is South Park, where it's Al Gore. They go Excelsior! In the goddamn battle already. Pull everything down then. Why are you wielding like that, you morons? This is some hard fighting right here. It's good though that these two haven't moved up. These two alone could just push me off. Not sure why the it seems like the game has broken down a bit here. Or an interesting new Confederate tactic here, deploying men like that. I'm not sure how long I've missed the time on this, but this is gonna be one long ass episode, I think. Our attack on a little round top. Actually, Perrin can hold there, just in case they want to try something for this point. Day. I really dislike you, Day. He was the one that held just here somewhere. I think we pushed back, Day. But Wright comes under a lot of fire there. Try again and we'll put everything on the line. Oh wait, that's okay. So much death, and everyone's just fighting over this little shitty hill. It's an important hill, because there's 300 points worth of it, or 3,000 points worth of it. get Fisher off that bloody hill. Sir, it seems within. Yeah, now the battle's gonna end. Come on, boys, one last effort. Crazy charge! It was a draw. We inflicted 500 more losses on the enemy. Most kills done by Kershaws than Wilcox, but they also lost a lot of men. Day's Brigade, yes, told you, Day's Brigade. Not only did he kill the most of all the Union Brigades, the bastard was hell. Strong Union boys on the Day's Brigade. God damn it, Day. The US sharpshooters killed a lot as well. Highest losses, Kershaw's brigade, Carr's brigade, Law's brigade. Yeah, Law's brigade lost a lot of men compared with what they killed. Anderson's as well, and Texas brigade. Everyone basically who held at Little Round Top or Round Top lost a lot of men. There's a lot of artillery units that got completely destroyed or went into red. What's the highest battery that killed? They had one that killed. Smith battery killed 600 men. And I'd had Patterson's battery kill 656. They only lost one guy, though. That's pretty impressive. Anyways, we're left with some new options here. Attack the Union Center. It's basically Pickett's charge. Go again on the left. Attack Culp's Hill with Anderson. Prepare a final strike but secure the flanks. Lot of interesting options, but we're gonna go into those for the next episode, which might just be, looks like they're gonna be maybe the last attack. Not sure if we've got any more in us to push them off. Anyways, I hope you enjoy this, and hopefully I'll see you guys for the next one. Bye.